I'd just like to, before we do the pledge and a moment of silence, I'd like to thank Legislator Kate Ebenelli for running the mock session. It was very interesting. It got started slow, but great job. And I'd like to thank you, young men and ladies, for participating. Mr. Neary, you ran a great session. Made me look a little weak. Melissa said she wants you to run the 10 o'clock session. But the social host law was very interesting. We jostled with those very same issues and questions that you had during the session. We passed it unanimously. And as far as the money, we were prepared, the whole legislature, to allocate $20,000 for the law. But the county exec and the district attorney assured us that we could find the money within our budget this year to get the message out. The county exec, myself, and the DA all did a code red in Montgomery. The town and village of Montgomery went out to 41. It's going to go out to 4,100 phones. So we are getting the message out, and we'll continue to do that. It's an important law, and we have unanimous support up here. But thank you again for your participation. Great job. Okay, please rise for a moment of silence and the pledge of flag. Okay, we've got three presentations at the beginning. Oh, roll call first, I'm sorry.
Bonacek?
Here.
Turnbull?
Here.
Amo?
Here.
Anagnostakis?
Present.
Benton?
Here.
Berkman? Vanelli?
Here.
Pantorino?
Here.
Cheney?
Here.
Dillard? DeSalvo?
Present.
Ekus?
Here.
Baggione?
Here.
Hines?
Here.
Chemnitz?
Here.
Pulisic?
Here.
Padoop?
Here.
Ruskevich?
Here.
Sullivan?
Here.
Vero?
Here.
Gresham?
Here.
19 ayes, 2 absent.
Okay, we have three presentations, as I said. The first is Autism Awareness Month. I'd like to invite Nadia Allen and Debbie DeJong up for that, as well as the Sexual Assault Awareness Month, same two people, and Michael Amo, who's been very active with the Mental Health Association. And the third proclamation, Susan Barron, Michelle Little, and Town of Warwick Councilman Floyd D'Angelo, and legislators Vero, Ruskevich, and Cheney for that one. Then we also have a ceremonial signing of the right for Valley View to raise funds for the non-for-profit. Is Nadia here?
Do
you want me to present him?
Good morning, everyone. My name is Deborah DeYoung. I'm the Associate Executive Director of Mental Health Association. And I'm here to acknowledge April as Autism Awareness Month. I want to take a moment to thank the Orange County Legislature and Orange County Executive Steve Newhouse for their support to Autism and to Mental Health Association. Over 12 years ago, Mental Health Association began a movement called the Autism Move-a-thon of Orange County. And this was started from a group of parents who themselves had children with autism who were dedicated to this mission of being able to create awareness for autism. If you've learned of the statistics, they're still quite staggering. One out of 68 individuals' children are diagnosed with autism. One out of 50 boys, in particular, are diagnosed with autism. These are staggering statistics. And we are so fortunate to have a group of dedicated parents whose mission is to continue the awareness efforts in Orange County and raise funds for autism. So I'm very pleased to turn the microphone over to Stacy Orzel, and her family. She has a son, Jason, who is a sibling of a brother with autism, and I think her words will be said best. So, Stacy.
Thanks, Debbie. I think this is our sixth year here, but our Monk organization has been in operation proudly for 12 years. This is our 13th year. A very proud mom of my 12-year-old son, Jay. He spoke to the group last year, and he has some inspiring words today. This is his younger brother, Eric. We worked with the state to create a Learn the Signs campaign for autism awareness throughout the state. You may see this poster in pediatrician offices, early intervention agencies, and throughout the community in libraries and places to help raise awareness and help a family that may be unsure if a child has a flag, possibly for an autism spectrum diagnosis. So we're very proud of that. We hope in his age and time, he'll be proud too that he helped other families. The Amok organization is a parent-run volunteer group. We're always outreaching for new volunteers. Volunteerism in the community is extremely important. Makes a nice resume piece as well. We have dispersed over $300,000 in the community in our 12 years in inception. We give a mini stipend of $150 to a child affected with autism on the spectrum to help them in the community with social skills, maybe sports, maybe music, things that the child might be able to do that maybe the family couldn't otherwise afford. The way to claim our stipend is simple. It's a reimbursement program. You can go on our website. We're in partnership with the Mental Health Association of Orange County. And there's some information on the back table, an orange slip of how to contact us. My Jason will say it best. He has some words of encouragement to share. So I would like to introduce Jason Orzel.
The great Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Keep that in mind. County Executive Newhouse has worked very hard in Orange County to make a difference for families and businesses. I watched his State of County speech on his website, and I learned that he's created many opportunities for jobs, cut down on tax dollars, encourages local purchases and partnerships, has helped grow the film industry, and has cut down on the time it takes for local vendors to get paid by 75% as of 2015. He has also helped two homeless veterans from Port Jervis find apartments this winter. He has also got much needed funding resorted for rape victims, which was cut last year. In our home, my parents and I worked hard helping my younger brother, Eric. I teach Eric how to be a good brother, help him with homework, deep end swimming, covering his sneeze for crying out loud, and soon to teach him to ride his bicycle with only two wheels, no training wheels. Together, we enjoy living room wrestling, video games, and speeding around campgrounds in golf cart that he would drove last time when we went to a trip, which I'll mention later. At the playground, Eric has great gross motor skills. He climbs up and over monkey bars instead of just hanging or swinging across. He can climb scaling walls and doorways by just using his hands and feet. Eric is often known to teach us other ways of doing things. We hope that always serves him well. Another strength for Eric is his amazing memory. He also has a great way of spelling on something we don't have in common. 4 years ago, Eric was here and at this meeting and he said the alphabet backwards. And he's now 9 and he can still do that. Can anyone here say the alphabet backwards? Once, twice, 3 times, sold to man in the tie-dye shirt. Most children with autism have challenging socializing. Eric does not initiate communication and he needs encouragement to approach other children playing. However, he is a great friend. Eric and his best friend Max are the recycle team in their class, and they have a secret handshake and cheer before they go recycling. He struggles with his fine motor skill abilities and does not like to write because that takes hand strength and he has low muscle tone. Cutting on the lines is also hard. He can cut out the shapes, but then I usually help him cutting on the lines. He also has a short attention span, and it's hard for him to stay focused. And generally, he also seems to hold back on certain things, like going in the deep end. He's not quite comfortable with it yet, but we're working on it. Eric is very smart, but he takes a lot longer to learn things sometimes. If you know someone with autism, please be patient. It probably will take that person longer to learn, listen, and respond. Family time is very important. We have to be mindful when we make family plans, because since Eric has some challenges. He does not like loud sounds or large crowds. We travel with headphones to help reduce the annoying sounds. Last fall, we went to Watkins Glen State Park for a three-night campout. Eric and I had lots of fun pooling, hiking, fishing, and driving around town through the rain half the time. Last fall, we also, our family has challenges going out since Eric has food allergies, but we decided to go to a Mexican restaurant. We sat down, Eric had some toys to play with, and it was a great experience. This was the first over 2-hour trip our family has made all together, and it was special. You would think that a trip that is more than 4 hours would be hard for someone with a person with autism, but it was harder for me to do it than him. Funny enough. About 2 months later, we went to Vermont to leaf peep, day hike, and hang out in my friend's Vermont house. Recently, over spring break, we went camping at a KOA in a log cabin for 2 nights. This is where we got a tour around the campsite in a golf cart by one of the workers there, and Eric drove it for half the time. And that was a first. We've gone camping a lot, but this is the first time in a log cabin, not to mention it was riverside, which is super cool. These trips are milestones for us. Our family likes to share this thought. Some people think inside the box. Some people think outside the box. Autistic people with autism think about the box. And Eric likes to play inside the box. I and some of my friends have been volunteers for a mock since we were 6 years old. I really think it's important to support people who need assistance. I have made some good friends because of volunteering. Thank you for having me speak today. I want to ask everyone to support laws, events, and causes that help families affected by autism and other disabilities. And in closing, please ask yourself every day, what are you doing for others?
Great job, Jason. Thank you to you, Debbie, Nadja, and everybody on behalf of the legislature for this awareness and the fight that you continue to do. So, the county exec's going to present a proclamation. It's a little lengthy, so I don't know if you want to read the top and the bottom.
I think it's very hard for anybody up here to sum up what Jason said. And we're lucky in Orange County, and the legislature and I have heard Jason before, and we're very obviously close with the Mental Health Association, and your mother was actually the paparazzi at the last dinner. But we do appreciate everything you said I think you summed it up better in here, so maybe next year when we do a proclamation, we'll have you actually help draft this. But you are really a role model, Jason, and what a good brother you are to take care of your brother and make sure that he has a great life and is part of our community. When I was younger, I never even knew what autism was. It was only about the last 10 years, Carol Klein, our family court judge, she couldn't be here today. She lost her mother this week. But she was the one that brought me into and explained to me what it is and how it affects people. And now that I'm a father of three young kids, when we go to other events and other families, on a regular occasion, we'll meet with a different family and one of their children would be on the spectrum. And now we're able to identify it and able to work with them and see how they can be active members of our community. And I think it's wonderful what you're doing, Jason. It's really all about awareness and opening up these doors of opportunity. And the walkathon, I went a couple of years ago too, and the district attorney was with me, the county clerk, and it was really enlightening, and what a fun day, and all the stuff you do afterwards. So, Jason, you really are a role model, and I know everybody on the stage is proud of you, so, as well as your mother. So thank you so much. I'm gonna present you with this proclamation. And I'm not going to read all the whereases, but I'll just say, on the top it says, Autism Awareness Month in Orange County. It's signed by both the chairman of the legislature, Stephen Brescia, and myself.
Thank you.
No, I just want to say, first of all, I apologize for being late. I have COVID, that's not the reason I'm late. There is an accident on 17A, so be careful going home.
We'll pick you up next time.
Pick me up next time. I just want to say that we've known this young man since he was 6 years old, and that to see him here every day, being so poised and so confident, and understanding the roles of siblings, of individuals who have autism or are on the spectrum, is really very important. And as you said, County Executive, nobody can say better than he does. But I think when I see somebody like Jason, even the restores our faith in the next generation of awareness, integration, and full participation of all individuals with disabilities as full participants of our community. So thank you, Jason. Thank you, the legislature. Thank you, Steve Newhawk, County Executive, for always supporting us in this initiative, and the family, ourselves, and all the MHB staffs. Thank you, and apologize for being late.
Thank you.
And a shout out to Dad.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
Dad.
Thanks again. So you have, it's a camera thing for the both of you, I guess.
Quick group photo. Yes, we are a paparazzi team. Thank you, honey. Thanks. Come down for a picture.
I just want the chairman and the members of the legislature and the guests in the audience to know the two young ladies that are here with me today. It is Youth and Government Day for some of the people that we're not involved in within it, just visiting. We have two young ladies. Heather is the furthest away from me. She's from Valley Central. And Melissa is from Middletown. And they are the representatives to the county exec's office today. We're having a lot of fun, and we're going to have a lot of fun, not only with this meeting, but at lunch as well. So, Mr. Chairman, just wanted you to say hello.
Hello, ladies. Okay, Michael Amo, you want to come? Oh, is he down already? He's on his way down. Okay, next up we have a proclamation for sexual awareness, sexual assault, excuse me, Awareness Month. Nod, you want to speak to this first? And
thank you. I'm so glad to see you, Legislator Amo. I mean, for those of you that don't know, he's also a director emeritus of the Mental Health Association, so we have a long-standing relationship with this this individual who's been a wonderful advocate for all the work that we do. As you all know, we're going to talk about the proclamation, but as you all know, sexual assault is not a discriminating crime of violence. It's a violence against women, and we really work very concertedly to ensure that our sisters, our daughters, our neighbors, our mothers, that they're safe every day. And I could not be happier than to understand the level of commitment that we have received from the legislature, from County Executive, from the District Attorney's Office, with the support that they have provided to this cause. And it's on us, which is a wonderful activity and initiative that we have, first initiative of a county that really embraced this initiative, making sure that there is a concerted effort to stop sexual assault on college campuses and the community, and don't be a bystander. It really happened in Orange County on a grander scale than any other county thus far, so we could not be prouder than to have that initiative happening right here in Orange County. And I do have to say that we have here our entire staff for our rape crisis program. And those of you that are, I'm not gonna call everybody, I'm gonna embarrass, just raise your hand, Debbie included, these individuals, Danielle, wave your hand, Jennifer, Kathy, all of you, these women, 24/7, 365 days out of the year, are out there responding to the needs of survivors and the families. So they need a round of applause because it's not a job for the faint of the heart. It's a job of compassion, love, and it's about a job promoting women's justice, including our sexual assault nurse examiners who do incredible work, retrieving the forensic evidence that's necessary to prosecute the crime. So thank you very much for the opportunity to speak, and I look forward to hearing the proclamation.
Just a quick one. Thank you very much, Nadia. It's funny, as I was sitting there and I saw the proclamation being given, it occurred to me when I joined the board in 85, I think I was on the Mental Health Association and president of, in the 90s. And I can think when we began this program, Debbie was around it, we were struggling for one person to work and respond to the calls to see the kind of people involved are amazing. And I think we all remember some of the lack of resources we had in terms of trying to meet women in the emergency room and being able to handle it. And to see it come this far is just spectacular. And I just want to say congratulations to the Mental Health Association and your leadership, because it's such an important issue, and you've done a great job making it all work. Thanks, Debbie.
Thank you to all you ladies. This is an issue that it's very close to home with me, and the legislature is fully behind you on your fight. Right? County Exec has another proclamation.
Yeah, we have. I am so happy that we're all here for this. I want to first thank the legislature. The legislature backed me 100% last year in funding the Rape Crisis Center, as well as Safe Homes, when we had gaps because of Albany didn't, when we were cut in Arizona. And we were able to fill that gap last year in the middle of the year, and then we also put it in the budget. It was not even a topic that came out of anybody's mouth. There was not one debate from Republicans, Democrats, Independent. So that's one thing that I'm very happy that we're working as a team on. The other thing is there's an article recently at West Point, and some of the service academies had an increase in sexual assaults. That is obviously a negative thing, but the positive thing about it is I think with awareness and accommodating survivors, it is now, because the numbers that we had last year, Nadia, were staggering. Almost one out of 25 students was a victim of assault. And a lot of them wouldn't come forward. And now that we have created and we're continuing to create a climate that it's okay to ask for help, it's okay, and it's the responsible thing to try to stop what's going on there and reversing those numbers. So it hits here in Orange County. And what the Rape Crisis Center does, and the young ladies over here, and what you said about a month ago at one of the dinners we were at where they dedicated some money to the Mental Health Association, where last year, when that funding was cut and they were going to shut down the Rape Crisis Center a few days a week, I think even on the weekend. So if an assault happened, and we have hundreds of assaults, unfortunately, every year, imagine that victim or the survivor not being able to have anybody to help them. Imagine the police or the emergency responders that come not having the support and education on how to treat a patient that has just become, that was just a victim of a sexual assault. So I'm proud to be here. It does hit home, as the chairman says, and we are heading in a positive direction. So what we have is a proclamation. Do you want me to read the whole thing, Steve? Okay, so I'll read the title. It's Sexual Assault Awareness Month. There's a lot of whereases, and I'm sure there's a lot of good numbers. So I'm gonna read some of the stuff. So our Rape Crisis Program in Orange County outreach to 4,093 community members in the last year or recently, right? I mean, these are. I'm gonna go through these, Steve. So we got time. I'll go quick, okay? The Mental Health Association of Orange County Rape Crisis staff provide training to law enforcement professionals, medical professionals, and community organizations. Mental Health Association of Orange County Rape Crisis sexual assault examiners provide forensic examinations and non-judgmental support to victims of sexual assault. And whereas it is important that the continued community education about sexual violence prevention and services for sexual assault and rape victims to be supported and enhanced. And whereas it's critical to create public awareness of sexual violence and support agencies providing sexual assault services. And whereas the Mental Association in Orange County Incorporated requests public support and assistance as it continues to work towards a community where all women, children, and men can live free from sexual violence and exploitations. And it's signed by the Chairman of the Legislature.
Thank you, Steve. I don't mean to abbreviate the proclamations, they're just lengthy. Mm-hmm. Schedule we have today. Thank you very much again. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Lloyd and the Humane Society of Warwick people, do you want to come up? Or do you want to get pictures first? Lloyd, if you want to introduce them, the three legislators I asked to come down. We have a proclamation too. I know the Warwick Humane Society is probably the preeminent humane society in the County of Orange, and we appreciate the job you do on behalf of the legislature. Thank you very much. Do you want to say a few words? Or?
Good morning, and thank you all, Executive Newhouse, sir, all your legislators. Thank you so much for having us here. I'm very honored to stand before you as the president of the Warwick Valley Humane Society, and also for all the other humane societies in our county who almost on a daily basis see some form of animal abuse come through their doors. We partnered with the ASPCA a couple of years ago to promote Go Orange for Animals, and we brought it up to Orange County. And because of your compassion for animals, we are actually able to stand before you and get it out into the public and make awareness available. Animal cruelty abuse has many facets. According to the ASPCA, an animal is abused every 60 seconds. We're very fortunate in our county to have a great DA who believes in prosecution of animal abusers. So when we do know that an animal is abused and we know who that abuser is, that person is charged, mostly convicted, and hopefully given the best sentence available by the law. Sometimes, as a humane society, we can't always charge the person, but we can get the animal out of that situation, which is one of the reasons we joined and partnered with Safe Homes of Orange County, so no animal has to be left behind in a violent home. And also that allows that person to not have to make the choice whether to leave that animal behind or not to leave at all. So that animal comes to the Warwick Valley Humane Society for safekeeping until he can go home. But then what weighs on us all day, every day, is that one animal every 60 seconds. It's the animals we don't know about that are being abused. And so that's why we ask, if you see their suffering, if you hear their cries, please be their voice. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Before I turn it over to the county exec, I'll just read you this proclamation. It's a little shorter, so. Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month. Whereas Orange County, the citizens of Orange County and the Warwick Valley Humane Society are concerned with the humane treatment of animals. And whereas the kind and humane treatment of animals has a strong correlation to the kind and humane treatment of people. And whereas animal cruelty has been proven to directly parallel violent and criminal acts of people. And whereas Orange County, together with the Warwick Valley Humane Society, urges the vigorous enforcement of existing animal cruelty laws in hopes of eliminating cruelty to animals, wild or tame. And whereas the Orange County would like to commend the Orange County Sheriff's Office, Orange County District Attorney's Office, local law enforcement agencies, and the Warwick Valley Humane Society for taking the necessary steps in investigating, alleviating, and prosecuting animal abuse cases. And whereas the month of April has been established as Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month, now, therefore, be resolved that I, Stephen M.M. Newhouse, an Orange County executive, and L. Stephen Brush and myself, chairman, do hereby proclaim April 16th as Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month. And signed by the county executive myself.
I'm happy to be here. I am biased with the Warwick Valley, because when I was town supervisor in Chester, they were there. We had a contract with them 24/7. Whenever the village of Chester police or town of Chester police or anybody called for help, you guys would come and send somebody and help. And I know two instances. One, my wife had called the village of Chester police that she saw a dog tied up in the snow, sleet, and outside all night. And we were able to not only remove that animal from that household, but also the village did violate the owners of that animal for neglect. Another incident, and this might sound off the rim, but this is how inclusive you guys were, and I know you know what I'm talking about. One day I came home from work as a supervisor. My wife was, I think, out with the kids, and there was a wild turkey walking around my yard, and it was like June or July, so it wasn't hunting season. and it had a play arrow sticking right through it. And the turkey was a wild turkey, but it came up to me, allowed me to pick it up. And I called the police and said, well, we have this contract with Warwick Valley Animal Shelter. The police picked me up. I rode in the back of this police car holding a turkey with a suit and tie on. And we bought it to there. Like, yeah, no problem. We're going to put it under surgery now. They saved the thing and let it go in the wild a month later. So that's the type of things they do. So it's not just domestic animals. And if you go visit them, you will see a wide variety, you know, of different types of animals that you help save. So it's about awareness to get the word out for people. If you see some type of neglect going on, it's not a big deal to call your local police department or your local town or village. I see Floyd here, where we can make a phone call, maybe save an animal. And I think it's all great stuff, and I appreciate you all being here, so I'm proud to have signed that as well.
Thank you again. I've heard some of your fish stories, but that was a good one. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Do you need a photo?
Sure. Come on in, everybody.
Stacey's giving Rodney some competition there. Thanks again, ladies. Okay. Thank you. Boy, thank you.
Now I got one of them.
Thanks. And finally, I'd like to call up Lawrence Ledoux, legislator Phil Cantorino, because it's his district, and chairman of the Mental Health Committee. You want to come up, Michael? Sure. I know there's quite a few legislators that supported this initiative. And Elizabeth Rowley, Biz Rowley, and the Community Foundation for her great agency making this possible. County Exec, you want to say something about this signing?
Yeah, I have to think Pat O'Dwyer's hiding in the back too. So what this will do is help bring in extra support to Valley View from people in the community that have extra assets, whether physical, maybe even money. Biz, you're the one that put together to make sure it was legal. And I think it's just a wonderful turn in direction that the entire county has taken now over the last, I'd say, 12, 18 months. And there's a lot of positive things going on there. I spent some time with Lawrence about, a month or so ago? And we met with every shift. As county executive, there's a couple departments that have 24-hour shifts. 911 Center, the Sheriff's Office, Corrections, we have some other agencies, but also Valley View is a 24-hour operation. So we did from 7 in the morning to midnight one night. So we had about 5 different shifts and got to talk back and forth directly with the employees and talk about what's on their mind, where the direction of the county is. And it was just a wonderful experience. So I think it's a positive day, and it's another good example of the direction the county's taken. And a lot of people that have worked in our county, the legislature and the department heads, are responsible for helping make that turn happen. Lawrence, you at the front of it. And I'm proud to be here today, so I'll pass it on. And I will say, I'll wait till after we're done. Actually, I'll say it now. Steve looks a little weird today because over the weekend, and I made fun of him a lot, but last weekend he shaved his hair with the help of a couple other legislators. I think it was John Bureau, Mike, and Mike Nagasakis, and Jim DeSalvo for the cause of the St. Baldwick's, which raises money for cancer. So we appreciate that. Obviously, it's not going to make it look any worse or better, but we appreciate the cause. And these are the type of things we're talking here about making a major difference now in Valley View. We've talked about domestic violence. We've talked about awareness with animal cruelty. But these are the positive things where you make a difference in our society. When you have young men like Jason that can talk from the heart about autism, and all these men and women here standing here that have really made a difference to help the men and women that are our patients at Valley View. So, Steve, thank you, and thank you for everybody else.
Thank you, County Exec, I think. Those three barbers, I don't know, I think I would have been better off with Sweeney Todd. Yeah, it's growing fast, right? Going fast and gray. But also, Councilman George Lyons is up here with his wife, Peg. We know they're big proponents at Valley View and for the cause, along with Pat. Who's going to speak? Lawrence, you?
I'll just say a few words. I just want to say thank you to Peggy and Pat. They're tremendous, and George, tremendous supporters and friends of Valley View. And on behalf of the residents, we're thrilled to sign this today. And we're going to be really thrilled to spend the money that you raise, and it's all going to benefit the residents of Valley View, so we're very excited about today. Thank you very much.
I just want to, for a minute, put a pitch in for people who want to help us get started. This is Friends of Valley View, and the Community Foundation very, very kindly has taken us in. And so we have a vehicle in order to be able to raise these funds to do and give some things to the residents that they cannot have through the administrative or the capital budget. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to have a prom. There are residents at Valley View who didn't have a prom, and we think they should have their prom. So we are going to hopefully have young men and women be the escorts for the residents who didn't have a prom, and we'll have a dance, and people will get certificates of appreciation for having graduated. So anybody who would like to contribute for corsages and boutonnieres and anything else, step right up. Oh, I'm sorry.
And if the handsome and beautiful ladies who go to high school, if you'd like to be an escort, it will be on a Sunday afternoon. We're thinking May 22nd. It'll be about 2 hours of your time. And I promise you, you'll have the time of your life dancing.
We'll teach you how to dance with wheelchairs. It's really very easy.
Biz, you want to say something?
Sure. Thanks for having me here today. I'm Elizabeth Rowley. I'm the president and CEO of the Community Foundation of Orange and Sullivan. We manage and administer all different types of charitable funds here in Orange County and Sullivan as well. So we're proud to partner with you two fine ladies and others who will be raising funds to support Valley View, and certainly you too, Mr. Ledoux. So we are here really for others in the audience or the education of the group too. We are here to help anyone who really has a charitable intent or a goal. We can set up essentially what is very similar to a private foundation or nonprofit organization through our organization, just like we've done for Valley View. So please don't hesitate to reach out to us if you know of someone who's looking to do that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now we have the ceremonial, or the actual signing, I'm sorry. Biz already signed and Patricia O'Dwyer signed. Thank you again, Biz, for making this happen. I know you do great things.
Good to go.
Good to go. Sign.
All right. Mark, make it official. Come on, it's unique. Not bad.
Great job, great job. Thanks again.
Here we go, thank you.
Buddy, we're official now, right?
Thank you.
Thanks, Lawrence.
Photo op, and then
photo op?
Do you want the paper back? Hold on, hold it up. Thank you. Come on in, ladies. Come on in, team.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
That concludes our business up here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. I gave it to someone here. Thanks.
Good. How you doing?
One second. Just want to remind Mr. Neary, when you were running the meeting and that outburst by Mr. DeSalvo, you could have asked him to refrain or have him escorted out of the meeting, just so you know. A fellow Highland Falls guy, no less, right? Heckling in the crowd.
Can we do that?
Keep it up, Steve. Okay, we got one speaker signed up, Willa Freeman, regarding the minimum wage, agenda item number one, which is going to be withdrawn, but you want to speak anyway.
Morning. Thank you for the opportunity. I am glad to hear that it is going to be withdrawn. I was here to encourage just that, and I want to start off with, I'm not an expert on wages, not a defender of any particular party, but I am here as an expert on women and women's issues. So I did want to just give you something to think about. Over the years in my profession, I have probably helped or advocated for women's issues. Well over 1,000 women have benefited from the work that I've done, and I'm very familiar with some of their plight. So I also, as a woman, know the cost of living. I know what it takes to put healthy food on the table. I know what it also costs sometimes to take care of aging and ailing parents. Given all that, I think it's really important to have that as the backdrop for what we know is going on in our county. There's a huge wage gap between men and women. It still exists. It shouldn't exist any longer. Women have really taken their lead in the community and in society. And over 50% of the people who are at minimum wage are women. And over 50% of the women are head of households. So given all that, they're under extra burden to really just become equal partners in society. The poverty rate in New York State is about 14.8. In Middletown, it's 19.4, and in Newburgh, it's 34.4. So here in Orange County, we really need to address the minimum wage issue. It won't solve everything. The resolution that has come from the state is incremental. I know that there are financial issues. I know you all have to balance all of those things. But let's just really work at solutions rather than criticisms. I really hope that we can, you know, get the entire supply chain from farmer all the way to the community. Everyone should be paid a living wage. Nobody who works full time should ever have to live in poverty, not in New York State, not anywhere. So instead of opposing the incremental plan to raise minimum wage, which I was disappointed to see you guys were about to do, but I'm really happy that you're not, I ask that you pull the resolution, but I also ask that you seek positive ways to close that gender gap. Thank you.
Thank you, Wilda. Okay, Majority Leader Bonasek.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to approve the minutes of February 4th and March 3rd, 2016.
Second. All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Majority Leader Bonasek again.
Thank you. I move to vote collectively on item numbers 19 through 23 and 34 through 36.
Second. All in favor? Aye. We'll speak at once. Opposed? Carried. If there are no objections, these items will be voted on collectively. Okay, are there any referrals, consents, or withdrawals? Legislator Hines.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. As Chairman of Public Safety, we did not have a quorum this month, so I have two consents. We did get full presentations on the first one from Colonel Decker of the Sheriff's Office and from Probation Director Miller on the second one. So the first one is a consent to add a resolution authorizing the County Executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept funds from the United States Marshal Service.
Second.
Okay, that'll be added.
And the second one is a resolution authorizing the County Executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Probation to accept funds from the New York State Office of Victim Services.
Second.
That'll be added as well. What numbers are those, Jean?
41 and 42.
41 and 42, okay. And Minority Leader Matt Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I requested item number 13 on the agenda, resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Department of Public Works, Environmental Facilities and Services Equipment for OCSD number one, $56,000 be withdrawn from the agenda.
Second.
I will be withdrawn. Anything else? Roseanne? I'm sorry.
I'd like to add by consent support of H.R. 4654, Keeping Communities Safe Through Treatment Act of 2016. And I believe Kelly is passing that out now.
Second.
Okay, that'll be added. Is that number 44?
Number 43.
43, okay. Stand corrected. Okay, anything else?
Yep.
Yes, Legislator Bureau.
I have one request to withdraw an item. Number 14 on the agenda, resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Department of Public Works, Environmental Facilities and Services, Design, Procurement, and Installation of a Meter System, Orange County Sewer District Number 1, $500,000. Be withdrawn from the agenda.
Second.
Okay, if there are no objections, that'll be withdrawn as well. Anything else? Paul?
Yes, I request that item number one on the agenda, a resolution opposing the proposal by Governor Cuomo to incrementally increase New York State minimum wage to $15 an hour be withdrawn from the agenda.
Second.
Okay, if there are no objections, that'll be withdrawn. Okay, we ready to go? Ready? I'll just say number, or letter A is a communication from James Burpo. Okay. And we're on to number two, right?
Okay. Legislators Amo, DeSalvo, and Chemnitz. Resolution confirming the appointment by the County Executive to the Orange County Board of Ethics pursuant to Local Law 5 of 2015.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Legislator Ekus and then Minority Leader Turnbull.
The first thing that I'd like to do is recognize Mr. Cooper for his service to the country in the Navy, and I want to appreciate that. But I also want to note that even from his resume, I'm going to have grave difficulty supporting this gentleman for the Ethics Board, and I hope people did their homework in looking at this. Thank you.
Okay. Matt?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yeah, it's come to my attention that perhaps the Board of Ethics is out of balance. There's supposed to be two appointments, or three by the County Executive and three by the Chairman, and one should be other than. And it seems to me like there is not an other than in one of the appointments. I'm not sure which one. So I would encourage the Chairman to look at this and let me know, you know, whether or not that's accurate. I would appreciate that.
There are three appointments by the chairperson of the legislature. I asked for one appointment from the minority leader, yourself, Matt. I asked one from the majority leader, and my appointment was a reappointment. So that's what it is, and I feel very comfortable. And the ethics board, Gail Cecina, as the seventh member themselves. So I feel very comfortable with the appointment that I've put forward. And this is the one that the Republican caucus put forward. Yes, Legislator DeSalvo. Yes, Ms. Bedell.
I would just like to remind everybody that when we did the revised ethics law that took place as of January 1 of this year, the makeup of the Board of Ethics was changed, and it is three from the executive branch, three from the legislative branch, and those six people are the ones that picked the seventh individual. And it is my understanding that, those six people have picked Gail Cecina, who is currently, or previously, the chair of the Board of Ethics, and she will remain in that position. So she's holding the seventh position.
Okay. We're good. Roll call, or you want to speak?
Just real quick. Mr. Cooper, on top of his impressive resume, is an outstanding fella. So I suggest if you have any type of inkling of doubt, that you reach out to him and have a conversation with him. You'll find out he's an outstanding citizen.
Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
No.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
Yes.
Benton? Benelli? Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? DeSalvo?
Yes.
Ekus?
No.
Baggione?
Yes.
Hines?
Yes.
Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan,
no.
Vero,
yes.
Gresham, 16 ayes, 3 noes.
Okay, number three.
Legislators Berkman and Kulisek. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature in support of Senate Bill number 6683 and Assembly Bill number 9455, an act to amend the penal law in relation to the sale and possession of fireworks in certain cities.
Second.
Discussion? Melissa? You want to be added? Okay. Yes, Mike? You want to be added? You want to speak, Chris, and then Matt? Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I have no problem with this, and I hope that the cities take advantage of this. As everybody knows, the town that I represent, New Windsor, also had problems, but they've decided that they're going to solve their own problems
by doing some education, but I think we as counties still need to do education. And I'm going to make one quick plea again, and that is that at the borders of this county on major roads, we put up signs, even if they're those temporary signs at important periods during the year, that say that fireworks are illegal in Orange County and should not be allowed. I think that's very important. That's the least we can do. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I second what Mr. Ickes just said. I mean, my area in, where I live in Hamptonburg was like a war zone last year. It was incredible. I think there's really a mystery to this war, and I think it's important that we let the people of Orange County know that we did not make regular fireworks legal in the county.
Thank you. I concur with you, gentlemen. And Phantom Fireworks is coming to public safety this month to speak about the educational aspect of it. And hopefully the municipalities will get code reds out and what is allowed and what is not allowed in Orange County. Okay. Without further discussion, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo?
No.
Ickes? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Pulisic, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham. 18 ayes, 1 no.
Bid number 4.
Legislators Amo and Pulisic. Amo and Chemnitz. Resolution approving 3 policy documents for the Department of Planning.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Pulisic, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham. 19 ayes.
Okay, resolution number 5.
Legislators Berkman and DeSalvo, resolution recognizing May 4th, 2016 as Holocaust Memorial Day Yom HaShoah.
Second.
Majority Leader Bonasek. All Republicans are added. Matt? Alton. Oh, you want to say something? Okay, all Democrats are added.
My esteemed colleague, Mr. Berkman, couldn't be with us today because of family matters, and he just asked me to thank the chairman and the legislature for this resolution. It's well appreciated.
Thank you, and Legislator Amo is added as well. Okay, roll call.
Oh, Chris, I'm sorry. No, that's quite all right. I don't want to belabor anything this too long, but this is for May 4th to dedicate this for those kids who don't know about remembrance of the Holocaust. And it's very interesting that the United Nations Security General Ban Ki-moon, at the time that they accepted this, said, "Let us all speak out against anti-Semitism and attacks against religious, ethnic, and other groups." And I think that's important in today's world. And I hope that we all just take at least a moment on May 4th to think about that. Thank you.
Thank you. Roll call. Michael.
I'm really glad that we're doing this, and I thank Berkman, Mr. Berkman, for putting it out. And in this sort of hectic era that we all are in Orange County, dealing with our conflicts in the southern part of the county, as we take that point that was just read by the previous speaker, can you imagine if in the last sentence we said, "Let us create a county where dignity is respected, diversity is celebrated, and peace is permanent."
Thank you. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 19 ayes.
Okay, resolution number 6.
Legislators Benelli and Paduk. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Parks, Recreation, and Conservation to accept grant funds from the New York State Office of Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes.
Again, Mr. Berkman wanted to thank the legislature and for supporting the Heritage Trail. He's very appreciative.
Wes wants to be added, okay. You want to be added? Anybody else want to be added? Roseanne? And why don't we add everybody unless there's any objections? Nope. No, no, one person, okay. Tom, okay. Okay, roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number seven.
Legislators Kulisek, Paduk, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Public Works Airport to accept funds from the Federal Aviation Administration pursuant to section 99-H of the general municipal law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
And number eight?
Legislators Benelli and Kulisek, resolution authorizing the county executive to accept a proposed right-of-way dedication parcel in the town of Goshen.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Thank you. I just want to recognize Assemblyman Carl Brabenick is in the back of the room as well. Thanks for coming, Carl. Okay, we're on number nine, I guess.
Legislators Kulisek and Riskevich. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature authorizing a fee acquisition under eminent domain procedure law of a parcel of real property situated in the town of Goshen, County of Orange, State of New York, in connection with a bridge replacement project known as the replacement of the Orange Farm Bridge No. 2 project.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 10.
Legislators Paduk and Turnbull, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQRA, with respect to the drainage rehabilitation project of County Road No. 60, making a preliminary determination that this project be classified as an unlisted action.
Second.
Okay, discussion? Roll. You want to be added? Melissa's added. And Melissa and Tom? Okay. Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 11.
Legislators Benelli and Riskevich, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQRA, with respect to the replacement of Gardnerville Bridge, making a preliminary determination that this project be classified as an unlisted action.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo?
Yep.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Number 12.
Legislators Paduk and Turnbull, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQRA, with respect to the replacement of Maple Glen Bridge No. 1, making a preliminary determination that this project be classified as an unlisted action.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonnesek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Corsack, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, 13 and 14 are withdrawn. Number 15.
Legislators Benton and Benelli, resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Orange County Department of Public Works, Environmental Facilities and Services, pursuant to section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 16. Did 15, yep, we're on 16.
Did 14. 15 we do.
16. You got 16 right in your hand.
16,
yeah,
I don't have the right.
We have these sold. Usually it's me.
Okay. 16, yeah. Sorry. Legislators Benton and Kulisek, resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 county budget for the Orange County Sheriff's Office pursuant to section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 17, bond resolution requiring 2/3 vote.
Legislators Benton and Hines, bond resolution dated April 8, 2016, bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing improvements to jail security systems at the Orange County Jail, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $500,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of 500,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Yeah. We want to be added. Melissa's added. Chrissy is added. Okay. And Tom Fagione added. Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresha? 19 ayes.
And number 18?
Legislators Benton and DeSalvo, resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Orange County Department of Finance, pursuant to section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. Yes. Kevin.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going to abstain because in committee I learned that they may be looking for outside law firms to bid on a project. I don't anticipate the firm I work for will bid on it, but just in case, I'm going to abstain.
Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 18 ayes, one abstention.
Okay, 19 through 23 are voted on collectively. Just a quick question on 19. We received the email from Matt from the county attorney's office. Is that still on there?
It's agenda item.
Okay, so 19 through 23.
Actually, it's the first item. Number 19 is the one that was added.
Okay.
Okay.
Second.
Okay. Roll call. Our discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 24.
Legislators Benton and Berkman, resolution authorizing a private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County, pursuant to section 10184 of the Real Property Tax Law and Orange County Amended Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Benelli. Pantorino. Cheney. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Ruskevich. Sullivan. Vero. Gresha. 19 ayes.
Day number 25.
Legislators Benton and Berkman, resolution approving the applications for correction of certain errors appearing on the 2016 tax rolls for certain towns and districts and ordering the correction of said errors pursuant to section 554 of the real property tax law.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Pantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, 26 through 33 are all bond resolutions requiring two-thirds votes. Number 26.
Legislators Benton and Benelli. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition and installation of computer hardware and software for the Department of General Services, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $2,300,000, appropriating said amount, therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $2,300,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
And number 27.
Legislators Ruskevich, Benelli, and Benton. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing financing for planning the replacement of Gardnerville Bridge in the town of Minnesink, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $125,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $125,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 28.
Legislators Paduk, Kulisek, Benton, and Hines. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing financing for planning the replacement of Maple Glen Bridge Number 1 in the town of Walk Hill, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $50,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $50,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis, Benton, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
And number 29.
Legislators Benton, Ruskevich, and Anagnestakis. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition of vehicles and movable equipment for solid waste operations at county transfer stations for the Department of Public Works, Environmental Facilities and Services, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $424,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $424,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Chris.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm really hesitant on this one. I don't sit on the Physical Service or Ways and Means Committees. However, this idea of purchasing new equipment to let non-county employees drive and use just doesn't seem like it's working out in our favor. And I'm wondering if anybody on the committee took a look and saw that, you know, are these purchases unusual in the sense that the folks that we contract with and then they subcontract with aren't abusing our equipment? And I don't understand why we can't, I would think this would be a perfect opportunity for us to slowly move out of the business of supplying this equipment to other companies to use. I will go ahead and vote for it because I'm going to make the assumption that my fellow legislators looked into this, but please, you know, I've all along commented about this whole idea of subcontracting out our waste disposal to other companies, and that it needs to be looked into. Thank you.
Okay. Yes, Perry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. In response to the question, the committee did investigate and discuss with Mr. Hammond and Mr. Vibrock the necessity for all of these items, and felt it was justified. The committee, I believe, voted unanimously to bring this forward to the legislature.
Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
And number 30?
Legislators Vero, Turnbull, Benton, and Benelli. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the reconstruction of County Transfer Station Number 2, located in the town of Newburgh, stating the estimated maximum cost of such project is $9,100,000, appropriating $4 million, therefore, in addition to the $5,100,000 previously appropriated, and authorizing the issuance of $4 million bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion.
I'd like to have my name added.
Hey, Kulisek added. Ickes added. Turnbull added or speak?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going to vote for this today, but you know, the information dribbles in. You know, I happen to be on physical services and ways and means, so when we request additional information, sometimes it comes in the next day. One of the things we found out was the square footage of the building was 20,000 square feet. According to my calculation, the $9 million total appropriated for this project is about $450 per square foot, which is, seems to be a lot of money for a building that isn't heated, it doesn't have air conditioning, doesn't have a lot of things that normal buildings have. So I'm going to, you know, keep my eye on this one. I want a little bit more justification for the amount of money being spent. I know that there is, I talked to Mr. Benton before the meeting started, there's a lot of specialty applications. It is mandated and there are time constraints. So I'll be supporting it, but I'm gonna be looking to see why the estimate is so high on this project. Thank you.
Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 31.
Legislators Riskevich, Kulisek, Benton, DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing paving of various county park facilities, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $225,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $225,000 bonds of the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 32.
Legislators Riskevich, Vero, Benton, and Anagnostakis. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing phase one acquisition of bedside cabinets for the Valley View Center for Nursing Care and Rehabilitation, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $71,500, appropriating said amount therefore and issuing the issue and authorizing the issuance of $71,500 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roseanne is added. Yes. Myrna wants to be added, and Phil Cantorino is added. Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yep.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
OK,
Okay, 34 through 36 are to be voted on collectively?
Do 33.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Okay. 33. Where's my backup, Mr. Neary?
Legislators Sullivan, Kemmons, Benton, and Anagostakis. Bond resolution dated April 8, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition of wheelchairs for the Valley View Center for Nursing Care and Rehabilitation, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $36,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 36,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Thank you.
Discussion? Roll call. Phil, you want to be added? Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, now 34 through 36. Okay. Yes? What's that? You want to be added on all three? All the Republicans? All Democrats? Michael? Yes, okay, everybody added. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
We're in the home stretch, Mr. Sassy. Making good time here. Okay, number 37.
Legislators Sullivan, Turnbull, Ekis, and Cantorino. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature and the Orange County Veterans Service Agency in support of hyperbaric oxygen therapy for treatment of traumatic brain injury and post-traumatic stress disorder.
Second.
Discussion, Chris.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd especially like to thank Mr. Anagnostakis for helping me get this through, health and mental health, and all the other legislators that made tweaks to it so that hopefully it will sail through here with a unanimous vote. And I appreciate that very much. I also would like to apologize to anybody out there who is offended by the term disorder, but it is PTSD, and so that's the proper title for it. So.
Legislator Amo.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We also in the Human Services Committee discussed this, and I think it's fair for the record to mention that we read pretty carefully, and with along with Mr. Anagostakis, who chairs the Health and Mental Health Committee, much of the literature that reviewed and researched the effective use of this particular intervention for PTSD. And what we really know is that the questions are larger than the answers, or there's more questions than answers, I should say, but we believe, and why we voted for this, and I hope everybody here will vote for it, is it really needs more research and it needs to proceed farther because this is such a horrific syndrome to deal with that we need to figure out the best way possible. So we want to all support it, and I hope everyone here does too.
Thank you. Jim, you want to be added? Myrna added. Michael Paduk. All Democrats. Do all Republicans want to? Most? Okay. All right, and Michael Amo. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
Yes.
Benton? Benelli? Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Number 38.
Legislators Anagnostakis and Kemnitz, resolution authorizing county executive to accept a donated speaker system on behalf of the Orange County Office for the Aging, pursuant to section 215 of the county law.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 39.
Legislators Anagnostakis and Cantorino. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Office for the Aging to appropriate grant funds from the New York State Office for the Aging pursuant to section 99-H of General Municipal Law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. Oh, yes, you want to be added, Rosa? Or, okay.
As a member of the Human Services Committee, I brought up a concern the day of the committee, and that concern was that, whereas I'm happy that we're getting these funds, the resolution is actually calling to appropriate it to give a raise to the direct care workers. And I spoke to Ms. McMillan about this, and what I told her was that I had complaints from senior citizens who live in my district who asked if somehow we could lower their costs, their portion of the cost. So my request was, can we take this money and apply it to the cost of the senior citizens rather than giving the direct care workers the raise? I'm sure they deserve the raise, but I think our main concern should be with our constituents' costs here. If we can reduce that cost in any way, then why not? I sent the name of the senior citizen to her, and I haven't heard back yet, so I don't know if she even discussed it with her. But I think that we have the opportunity right now to take that money, and instead of giving the direct care workers the raise, I would like to take that money and reduce the cost of the senior citizens instead.
I just want to comment on that. The grant funds are coming from New York State, and they dictate how those monies are going to be spent. So if there's any discretion, the individual who would know that would be the director, and I don't think that we should take it upon ourselves to violate the guidelines or the grant requirements by changing where those monies could be allocated to.
So she might have the discretion of doing that?
I don't know. She would know the guidelines and the requirements for accepting the grant.
Would anyone here be interested in tabling it until we find out for sure?
I personally don't think we should table it. I mean, I think Legislator Amo can get those answers at the next Human Services Committee, but I hate not to accept this grant today.
Yeah, I think, yeah, I'd be glad to see if we can get an answer and have Anne-Marie bring it to us. I think it'd be a shame to set aside what is valuable resources for the hardworking caregivers we have, although your point is well taken. And, you know, maybe there is a way that we can do both in some way. And I think that's really what you're asking. I don't think you're saying we don't want it for one. Why can't other people have it too? But maybe we should. I'd be willing to listen to Anne-Marie at that meeting.
Danielle Diana Smith, are you prepared to answer any questions?
I mean, all I know is it is a pot of money that's coming down from the state government, but it is specific to the direct care worker. And again, it's not something that we have the discretion. I mean, they're saying, here's the funds, and this is what you can use it for. So it's specific to the direct care workers.
Okay.
I mean, you can certainly, Anne-Marie's in the building somewhere. I mean, if you want me to find her.
Well, as long as you know that you do not have the discretion to do that, then that's fine.
To the
direct
care worker.
That's the answer that I needed.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Danielle. Okay, any other questions? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Corsett, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Biro, Gresham, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 40.
Legislators Anagnostakis and Cantorino. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Office for the Aging to accept and appropriate reimbursement funds from Legal Services of the Hudson Valley pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekus? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Corsett, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresham, 19 ayes.
Okay, 41 and 42, Legislator Hines explained earlier. Number 41.
41, Legislators Hines and Bureau. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept funds from the United States Marshal Service pursuant to Section 99-H of a general municipal law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
Benton, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 42.
Legislators Hines and Vero. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Probation to accept funds from the New York State Office of Victim Services pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Conasec?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yep.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Final resolution number 43.
Legislator Sullivan. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature for the County of Orange of the State of New York to the President of the United States, the United States Congress, and the Office of Justice Programs in support of H.R. 4654, Keeping Communities Safe Through Treatment Act of 2016.
Second.
Discussion. Legislator Cantorino.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Going through this resolution and also the proposed bill, first of all, I want you to know that I support this wholeheartedly, but I think we can strengthen it, and we really need to take a good look at this thing to help this bill along and make sure it does what it's intended to do. There are a couple of issues of clarification. Talks about low-level drug crimes. It talks about low-level offenders engaged in drug activity, and then it allows the law enforcement officer to make a determination. Well, I don't know what a low-level drug activity is, and I don't know if that includes the dealer, a distributor. This law seems to really point at getting help and sending the people who use drugs to facilities that would help them overcome their addiction. But there may be drug dealers that distribute these that don't need to go to these facilities, but it doesn't clearly specify that. So I think it's not a time-sensitive bill because it was just referred to the committee on April 1st, it was written March 1st of 2016. And I would really like to help this bill along and make sure that the people that are distributing drugs, and also it specifies violent felony offenders. And I'm not sure what that means. It does say in accordance with Section 3559C2 felony has the meaning given to such terms, Title 18 of the United States Code. I think we really need to understand what we're doing here. And I think even the bill that's proposed by the Congressman needs to be more specific and more helpful. So it would be my recommendation that we all take a good look at this. We only have it 2 or 3 days and help strengthen this bill. Once again, conceptually, I agree with it 100%, but I think we need to
point of order. Like,
yes.
I just wanted to ask, before we start making amendments, can I please have a moment to introduce this bill, this resolution? Thank you.
Okay, memorialization, yeah.
Yes, please, memorialization.
I was very pleased to read that our district attorney and our local police chiefs gathered to show support for Congressman Maloney's law, Keeping Communities Safe Through Treatment Act of 2016. This new outlook, this new mentality, which has already been implemented in other states, by the way, treats drug addiction as an illness, both physically and mentally, that leads to crime. For so long, we've actually thought that locking up our drug addicts actually works. Not only is this not smart, but it wastes so much taxpayers' money, which was actually a quote in the paper, I believe, from the DA, not a direct quote, but he actually pointed out that a facility that could actually help a drug addict overcome his addiction would actually be cheaper than locking that person out, letting them back, and letting them out, and then letting them back in again. I'd like to applaud this effort, and I'm proud to present this consent memorialization to you so that we may also, along with the DA's office, along with our local law enforcement, send a message that we stand behind Congressman Maloney in his response to the growing heroin and opiate epidemic, which affects every single county resident, regardless of age or socioeconomic status.
I'd just like to say that five legislators were there at a meeting for Camp LaGuardia when, right after the press conference, and I think you're going to have a lot of support for this, but I think with the time sensitivity not being such an issue, I think that's what Mr. Pantorino is suggesting. Send it back to committee for a month and then...
The reason I'm saying this is not because of the bill and the motivation for this bill. I totally agree with it 100%, but I don't want it left up to interpretation. I don't want the law enforcement officer out on the street to start making decisions on drug dealers, because this bill that Congressman Maloney wrote does not specifically talk about dealers. It talks mainly to the to helping the drug addicts along. Well, I don't want to see any drug dealers go to a facility, even if they're not on any type of drugs. And this is the distribution of not only heroin, or it could be pills or whatever. So it doesn't address it at all. And I really would like to help Congressman Maloney clarify this so it doesn't go up for interpretation, it doesn't go before the courts, and no one knows really what is said. We haven't looked at this thing, and I don't think he has really looked at it clearly. I know what the intent is, and I agree with you. I'm not disagreeing. I think we should table it and maybe ask a few questions so that we avoid misinterpretation going down the road.
I would suggest that you table it for 1 month, or send it, it's not back to committee because it didn't even go to committee, but
right,
it would go to rules and public safety.
Yeah.
And I think just to get a lot of clarity on questions.
That's all. Just
so
just
is that what your motion will be?
That's what my motion will be.
And Michael, and Jim, were you just wanting to be a sponsor, or were you wanting to speak?
No, I was wanting to speak on it.
Okay, then we jumped around. You speak, and then we'll talk on the motion to, yeah, I guess we're on the motion to send back to committee or table for 1 month.
1 month,
refer,
30 days.
Refer to,
yeah,
committee.
Just understand.
Okay, and Michael seconded that. Okay, you want to speak on that, Jim? You had your hand up a while ago.
Well, there's an opioid epidemic that has been building for many years. Everybody always thought it was an inner city problem, but now it's reached out into the suburbs. This is a pilot program. It's going to be fully vetted before it becomes law, and I think that we should go ahead and show our support for this now.
Okay. Michael, and then Kevin.
I seconded Legislator Cantorino's motion. I think his points were really good, and as someone who spent time in healthcare, I have a lot more questions that he didn't even ask, let alone the other ones. And it, really, I think that we gotta support this concept, because I agree with Mr. Krueger said in this one, but we have to support this concept. But are we prepared, and do we have the capacity in Orange County to be able to carry it out if it passed? I'd want to ask Commissioner Miller, do we have the capacity to handle this, to do this? How are we going to do it? Just that little bit of discussion. If everybody's comfortable, I'm a yes vote. I'm not behind it. But I think because there is not that urgency to put it on by consent, I would hope that it would go back to committee and just have that opportunity to say, look, let's have the experts in this field talk to us just a little bit about it so we know what we're doing, and then move forward. Thank you.
Okay, Legislator Hines.
Yes, I was lucky enough to have some time to speak to the DA last night. He really explained a lot of this to me, because I didn't understand the law as much, but it was really great. He said that no drug dealer would qualify for this. And keep in mind, this is a memorialization. We're not going to be able to change in federal law. So because it's a memorialization, I'm all for voting for it today. The DA had spoken to Congressman Maloney, and he said it's their intention to have a pilot program of this, that it won't be countywide from the get-go, whether it be in Newburgh or Port Jervis or one of the cities possibly. And what he told me, and what I learned, was the police officer will not bring the person into custody into the police station. The police officer will bring that person into custody and bring them right to a treatment facility. so you don't have the judges involved, you don't have the DA's office even involved. That police officer says, listen, pal, you're either under arrest or you're going to whatever treatment facility we have to offer. And they, at that time, will have to sign a 30-day commitment that you are now in basically the custody of this treatment facility. And that's the start of the program. And if they say no, or if they try to leave early, then you're getting arrested and going through the system like everybody else. There's another component of this that's very important, and that is who's going to pay for it. And the DA said part of this bill has to include that Medicaid will pick this up. So that's, there's another portion of this that hasn't even been introduced yet. So there's plenty of time to work on this. Most of the people that get arrested for heroin and these drug violations do not have health insurance unless they're under 26 and are covered by their parents. So Medicaid has to pay for this before it even is implemented. So yes, there's plenty of time, but I don't see a reason to delay it because it's a memorialization. I think everybody realizes that we have a growing drug population in Orange County, as Mr. Kulosek said, even outside the cities. I'm for passing it today because the feds have a ton of work to do on this, and we're not going to change what they're doing. And anybody can call Congressman Maloney or the district attorney. I'm sure they'll be happy to discuss it with you.
Senator Bernelli.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I'd like to echo all the sentiments made by my colleague, Mr. Hines. This is a consent resolution. It was a concern as how time-sensitive this is. This has just been introduced in the House, from what I understand. But I had the fortune also to be able to talk to the district attorney. Had I not had that opportunity, I don't know if I would have been prepared to vote for it today, since it is not time-sensitive. But given the fact that I did have that opportunity last evening along with some of my colleagues, I am fully prepared to vote for this today because I don't see sending it back to committee. It's really not going to change my mind personally because I've gotten all the answers that I need and the questions I had from the district attorney. But I happen to be in the right place at the right time.
I was about ready to be ready to vote to send it back to committee, but I think I'm ready to vote on it today. I mean, you know, we could tweak it a little bit more in committee, but it's sending the basic message. It's not going to change the law, as Kevin said. So why don't we just call the roll call on the, okay. Phil, talk, and then we'll go vote on the motion to send back to committee, because we don't need to debate this for an hour whether we're going to send it back to committee.
No, not at all. I did talk to the district attorney last night, too. I still had the questions, but I'm prepared to move forward and vote for it because of the concept. But I think we need to investigate this real clearly so we help, because the law enforcement officers do not have this type of training. I was the commissioner of police in Goshen, New York. I know that they do not go through any of this training, and for him to make a decision on what to do with a drug offender or is going to be very important. So I think we should do diligence. I'll vote to send this forward. That's not a problem, because I'm on board with the
You want to withdraw your motion then?
So I'll withdraw my motion.
Okay, thank you. Michael, you want to withdraw? You want the vote? All right. Are you speaking on the motion to send back? Okay. So you're on an island now. You're going to make the motion? Is somebody going to send second Michael's a motion to send it back to committee now?
I'll second.
You'll second it? Okay. Paul, you want to speak on that?
I'm not opposed to this. I think it's a good thing. My issue with it is the process in which it came to us. This doesn't need to be a consent resolution. There's no urgency time-wise to push this through. I think it could have gone to committee. I think some of these questions could have been answered ahead of time. All of us would have had the chance to hear from the DA. I did also speak briefly with him last night. I am comfortable with this. Voting for it. However, I think there's a time and a place for consent resolutions. You know, the two previous ones, that was definitely a time for consent resolution, very appropriate. This, I don't think, is appropriate for a consent resolution. So therefore, I would be comfortable sending it back to committee, but if we do a vote on it today, I will support it.
And I will say in that respect that I would appreciate these going through committee, because I think in the next year and a half we're going to get a lot of consents this way, and many of them can go through committee. And we get arguments the other way when we do this, and we've done it many a times with consents. We get arguments that, I got this last minute and I can't vote on it. And then some of the same legislators that say that expect their consents to go through the same way that they just opposed. So, all right, roll call on the motion to send back to committee.
Yeah, we did. We had a new motion by Michael Amo and seconded by Paul. So motion, a roll call on that.
Bonacek?
No.
Turnbull?
No.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagustakis?
No.
Benton?
No.
Benelli?
No.
Cantorino?
No.
Cheney?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
Yes.
Ickes?
No.
Fagio?
Yes.
Hines?
No.
Hemnitz?
No.
Pulisic. Paduk?
No.
Riskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
No.
Bureau?
No.
Brescia?
No.
5 ayes, 14 noes.
Melissa, you asked me earlier about all Republicans going on this. Is that still the case? Or?
Before I do that, there were some Republicans who voiced some concerns today. Are we still all on board to at least go on now as sponsors?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, could you please add all Republicans?
Matt, you want to speak?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I can say this is a step in the right direction. You know, they've done similar laws in other states. They've been enacted long enough to see the results. We got to start treating addiction as a sickness. Many of you know that I'm a recovered person. Let me take that back, partially recovered. You know, Legislator Sullivan said it's physical and mental. Told me on the basketball court you would know that I recovered 100% physically. If you saw my performance as a legislature, you might question if I'd recovered 100% mentally.
I knew that was coming.
But, I'm on the board of ADAC. Had conversations with Mr. Conklin about this, and they're going to put the money into allowing an addict to get recovery. The problem is there's a long line waiting to get into recovery, so it's kind of putting the cart before the horse. Recovery typically, especially for those addicted to opiates, is a process. Rarely does the person not rescind. So if they don't have a long-term program to go into, it's very unlikely that they're not going to end up going back. You know, the thing that makes this so challenging is that many people who work in this field, even those who are addicted, think it's about a decision. And that's where, I went through a 6-year process. By the way, I celebrated my 35th anniversary last St. Patty's Day. It just doesn't happen, that they, end up recovering first time. It's rare, so the conversation I've had with Mr. Conklin, the point I'm making is that sometimes it seems to me that the people that know the most about this particular problem are used the least, ADAC is the group that's been in the trenches. They're the ones that really know about this, and they're really not supportive of this. I am, because I think it's a step in the right direction, and I think New York lags in progressive solutions to this particular problem. So I'm going to vote for it. And I wouldn't even say I'm voting for it reluctantly, because my hope is that this is a step in the right direction.
Thank you, Matt. Roll call? Yes. You want to be added?
I won't be added, please.
All Dems? Any Dem that doesn't? Okay. You want to be added, Michael? No, thank you. Okay. Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
No.
Ed Agnostakis?
Yes.
Benton? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Pulisic? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 18 ayes, 1 no. The desk is clear.
Yeah, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Okay,
we're adjourned. The lunch is at the Holiday Inn, I believe. And in the town of Walk Hill on Crystal Run Road.
Yeah, go.